Welcome back. Today we are discussing topic about inspectors and mine officials, chapter 4 of the coal mines regulation 2017. As per the any official have a certain qualification to get the good position. Like that, the qualification of the inspector. The inspector must have in degree in mining engineering, like that a graduation in mining, and first class manager certificate for underground. Such inspector not at all for the single discipline, like that especially for the mining. That inspector regarding for mechanical inspector, might be electrical inspector, might be medical inspector. So, shall have a degree in respective discipline, and the mining inspector had also required for first class mines manager certificate. And next, qualification and appointment of the manager. For every mine, such an aspects, the manager should be appointed and certain specializations for open cast and underground, as well as these conditions. To be appointed as a manager, he must be not less than 25 years of age, and also he has the responsible person to the mine and only answerable to the owner or agent of the mine. So on that condition, for cluster of below ground mines, nothing but underground mines, if the more than 2500 tons per month production wherever available, is it in case of the possibility of that much of tonnage of production, there is a first class manager certificate unrestricted should be required for that. But where within 2500 tons per month, the first class or second class mines manager certificate with unrestricted. And coming to the open cast mines, if the more than 20,000 cubic meters per tonnage of material handled, there is not for extraction of the tonnage of production. In open cast mines, there is only, we are calculating the cubic meters per month, which is more than 20,000 cubic meters per tonnage, cubic meters per month of the material handled, there is a first class manager certificate holder is required. But within the 20,000 cubic meters material handled per month, there is a first class manager or second class manager certificate holder should be required. Then coming to the point, if the mines have both open cast and underground working to have first class manager certificate, should be unrestricted certificate holder irrespective of the production. The person with lower qualification shall not replace the manager except with the prior permissions by the written by the owner or the manager, owner or agent during coming 12 months. Next 12 months, if any reduction in the average output earlier standard should be held. Example, we are taking 12,000 tons per month for this year in underground mines. We can hold on that particular 12,000 tons per month. We can take a benchmark for the next academic year, next succeeding coming month. We can take a benchmark like that. A permission can be granted and conditionally. Such a person appointed as a manager only to one mine. The appointment is also effective only for 12 months. Wherever a person as a manager or an official appointed also is only effective for the 12 months. Thereafter, it must be renewal to the DGMS. If the CA finds that the manager is unable to exercise effective supervision, he may vary or revoke permissions. Can revoke any with the condition of changes. Like simply, he is not satisfying by the chief inspector that the manager unable to exercise or unable to verify his duties properly or is not effective supervision, the chief inspector may take revoke on him. Example, in the case of where second class manager is appointed for the some given conditions of the productivity, later if the condition is already needed the first class manager, the chief inspector can order to first class manager. Like that. If the regular manager is absent or unable to exercise daily personal supervision, the authorized person, another person will writing by the mine, by the owner or agent shall authorize to the mine for accessing of the person. The new manager should has old manager certificate. The new authorization valid for 30 days only, unless previous consent of the CI means chief inspector is obtained. When the authorization is made immediately intimate to regional inspector by post of any authorization of the regions, by mail or post, to intimate information qualifications and exercise to the person authorized. When manager wants to vacate his office, the notice at least 30 days before to be intimate to the owner and the agent. The owner agent not to transfer, discharge, to dismiss a manager unless another qualified manager is posted. If he is not sufficient to work there, he is not to be good exercising work to be supervising, he must be take to the charge until the another manager has to be appointed. The authorization, the owner, agent or the manager have to write to authorize under qualified person as manager only if the regular manager is absent due to the illness or any other cause. So the authorization is under qualified person not more than 60 days. The owner agent to provide residual accommodation manager around the 5 km distance. Around 5 km distance. The manager shall reside in the accommodation should be provided by the qualified persons. Like that, in case of the private company, that company to be provided to him an accommodation around the periphery of the 5 km distance. If there is any special difficulties to appoint a qualified manager, the chief inspector may exempt the form this required. The manager shall not be entrusted any work which may be frequent prolonged absent from the mine. The manager simply reject him to revoke into the position. The manager shall not act as a manager or in any other capacity in the mine where he is working for some time. The charge report of the manager. Outgoing manager to hand over the incoming manager means every details and every records to be hand over to the who is coming to the next manager. The charge report to be signed both outgoing and incoming managers in the by the regional inspector and should be sent to the regional inspector. That copy and particular details has to be submitted by the old manager of the mine, and the qualification and appointment of the safety officer. So that the appointment has to be done of the safety officer underground mine if the average monthly output is 5000 tons. It's a more than 5000 tons. If the open cast mines where monthly material handled is more than 20,000 cubic meters. So as well we have discussed in the above section. So like that, simply the below ground mine average monthly output is more than 15,000 tons. The safety officer to be first class mines manager certificate to be holded. to have unrestricted certificate. The open cast working average monthly material handled if more than 50,000 cubic meters, the safety officer to be first class manager. In underground mine also, the average monthly output is 10,000 to 15,000 tons capacity. There is must be required first class or second class mines manager certificate holder can be also as a safety officer. Is unrestricted certificate. The mine with only open cast mines with average monthly material handled between 20,000 to 50,000 cubic meters as simply as first class manager, and underground mines for average monthly output is 5,000 to 10,000 tons, he is unrestricted with first class or second class manager certificate. He is considered as a safety officer. He must be qualification as a diploma in mining engineering and degree in mining engineering holder. He can also be a safety officer. Under difficult or special conditions, CMA permit appointed as the safety officer in different variations by the written certification. It may be specified qualifications. The appointment of the assistant manager. All of you people, you must note down, this is the most important chapter for you as a competitive question. And next, coming to the point, appointment of the assistant manager. The manager shall be assisted by the assistant manager simply, so that some in specializations in the specific cases the chief inspector may realize the requirement of the assistant manager. The application and appointment of the ventilation officer in the first degree gassy mine with average output more than 5000 tons and the ventilation officer to be appointed. In the second or third degree gassy mines, if the average output exceeds 2500 tons, the ventilation officer should be appointed. And this ventilation officer also carries duties as assistant manager. The first degree gassy mine with average output is more than 15,000 tons, the ventilation officer should be a manager certificate holder. It must be important. Note on this point, you guys. If the more than 15,000 tons capacity in the first degree gassy mine, the ventilation officer should be first class mines manager certificate holder. In the second class, second degree and third degree gassy mines with production is more than 10,000 tons, a manager certificate holder should be a ventilation officer simply. There is a 15,000 in the first degree gas mine, 15,000 tons. In second degree and third degree gas mines, where production is more than 10,000 tons, there is a ventilation officer should be appointed as a assistant manager. And in some cases, in the first degree gas mines with output is less than 15,000 tons, it should be considered the CMA permit combining post VO and SO. Note this, whenever the output is less than 15,000 tons, the assistant manager, like the safety officer and ventilation officer, should be carrying both duties. The output, average output for the monthly, the exceeding of the financial year, will award working for all seams. The mine consists in the different seams in the different gassy nature to be compensated with a high degree of gassiness. That is depend upon the appointment of the assistant manager. Next. Appointment of the engineer. This is the point of view, as a mining engineer we cannot get as an engineer. Why? Because it is the considering as a mechanical or electrical department. So wherever any mystery used in underground mines, we need to know the particular details about where engineer should be required. Why? Because in the future almostly the total mining machinery simplified, the semi mechanization also completely converted into the completely mechanized mines, so that we need to know wherever the requirement of the mining engineers for the requirement of the mechanical machineries or anywhere electrical assignments wherever working in the mines, so that the responsible of installation of the maintenance safety working is necessary for the machinery, so that can be holder a degree or diploma in the mechanical or electrical or mining machinery. Degree holders should be appointed as a mining engineer, engineer, so that also you can identify that in previous we just listen whenever we are studying at a period, the mining machinery in the graduation, in the degree, also one of the courses exists in the JNTU, so that in the mechanical or electrical and also mining machinery with the degree holder, he should be appointed as an engineer. He is also subordinate to the manager. In the mine where electricity is used, which is exceeds 650 volts and installation capacity of the electrical equipment 1.5 megawatts or more, the electrical engineer shall be charge of the electrical equipment. This post is additional to the engineer's post. In the open cast mines, where the consideration of heavy earth moving machinery, or in underground mines where heavy machinery is used, in aggregate horsepower is exceeding 1500 horsepower, in degree or diploma in mechanical or mine machinery shall be additionally appointed as a in charge of the mechanical equipment shall be used. This post is additional to the engineers in charge of the post, so that more than one engineer can be also employed for the similar work. Jurisdiction and sphere of the responsibilities to be defined by the manager. Any mines in some special conditions may need to special qualification of the engineers, so that the chief inspector may order to the person of additional qualifications in the interest of the safety. The person can act can be appointed engineers of the only to the one mine. The chief inspector may conditionally permit appointment in the more than one mine. That permissions for not more than 12 months can be renewed, so that any official to be appointed, that appointment only valid for the 12 months. After 12 months or before or of 12 months, it should be renewed. So for authorization, another engineer notice to be sent is valid for only 30 days. In the case of any temporary absent of the engineer or the manager, it should be authorized by chief inspector or in case of mines manager for suitable person to act as in role. It should be valid for the 30 days. The appointment and qualifications of the senior officials. One or more overmen shall be appointed as a in charge of different district. Like that, in the board and pillar method, there is a number of districts and number of pillars. There are the different type of panel workings, so that every area has to be a superior worker. Like that, a competent person should be appointed as a safety aspects to maintain that. So that the particular person is a overman, should have number of working places, the number of overmen should be appointed as a in charge to the different places. The overman district size should be, can work easily and fully. It is the very tolerant places. He should not be given an additional duties, which may be prevent him from the carrying out the mentioned duties. So that, like that, in that cases, the overman take his duties as a particular safety way. Next, appointment of the surveyors. One or more surveyor holding certificate holder should be appointed to carry his surveying and leveling and prepare plans and sections. In every mine, in underground or open cast mines, the surveyor should be important to all of the mines. So surveyor cannot be appointed as a more than one mine, but one surveyor should carry his work, particularly for open cast mines or underground mines. For specialization, only required to, in case of the open cast mine, he will work for only open cast mines. In case of the underground mines, he can work for only underground mines. The number of surveyors required to be specified by the board in the case of the basic working positions in the underground or open cast mines, in the basis on the panel lengths. Next, the chief inspector may relax the requirement of appointment of the surveyors. Is there any more than one surveyor in the mine, the duties and responsibilities and the section of workings to be assigned in writing in the specialization in the certain writing notice. If the any more than more number of surveyors, the one shall be appointed to the responsible for the preparation and maintenance of the required plans and for coordination of the overall supervisor. So friends, this is our topic today. We have discussed it. So I think so it is most useful to you, and this type of all documents is available at our website miningtechnology.in. If you want to more, you can download from it and also you can buy from it. And some more different type of subject material also available on our website. And please subscribe our video and please share our video and must be subscribe our channel to get more videos like this. Thank you friends, thank you very much.